Simon Cafferty for Split Decision MMA UK here at Cage Predators 1 in Blackburn, and I'm here with the new welterweight champion, Matt Williams. Thanks for joining me. Firstly, how does it feel to be the new welterweight champion?
I'd say I feel really great, but I do feel a little bit tired. Need a breather, but no, I'm absolutely buzzing. I can't believe it. When I found out this morning I was fighting for the belt, Rob woke me up, he was like, such a person might not be fighting now, so you'd probably be fighting for the welterweight title now. I was like, oh, cool. But I thought you'd be more confused about that. I was like, you just woke me up. I'm ready for this. First thing in the morning, I want some porridge. I'm like, no, not losing fighting for a title.
And no, that's why I'm like in the morning. If anybody rings me at like whatever time, anything before 12, that's how lazy I can be as a student. And people just go, you're doing this, you go, really? You could be telling me I'm winning £1 million right now, son, but I am not getting up. But once he told you and you came to and I'd got felt good, did it change your mindset going into the fight knowing I'm going for a title now?
No, I was a little bit, it put a bit more pressure on, a few more nerves. But as I was talking to somebody, both from Manchester Predators, fighting for a weight title, I can't remember his name, but like he said, he goes, look, this is just a normal fight, it's not a title fight, it's just a fight. Win, lose, you'll take something from this. Be it good or be it bad, you can improve on. So that was literally two fights before mine. It completely calmed me down and settled me down, and a lot of calmer in my performance and a bit of great advice, really. Really, really took that on. It helped calm me down.
And inside the fight, you did look really calm, especially that first round. Once you got him down, you took full mount and you were picking your shots really well. Did you think you were close to finishing it at that point?
Yeah, and then I thought I was close to finishing. I heard the ref say you got to defend yourself, and then I heard 10 seconds. And as much as you're throwing them 10 seconds, you know full well, in the ref said, he's like, he's gonna survive 10 seconds. So be that 30 seconds left at fight, I reckon I could have finished it then, but a win's a win, and I had to fight two more rounds, so it was more round time, more experience.
And especially in the second, he got I think it was an arm triangle on from the bottom. I think it was that.
I just felt uncomfortable, a little bit like oh, but then after that initial oh, like because when anyone grabs you for, I was just like right, I've never really been in this position before. I don't really know what I'm doing, because he's like, he didn't take my back or anything. If he took me back, then I'd have known what to do, because it would have only been one hook at the time, so I'd have rolled out and got half guard. But it was weird. I was trying to hear what my corner was saying, but because he was on that side, I couldn't really hear what they were saying. I think they said something like, put your arms to the mat. I don't know whether. What was being said, I was just really confused. And I had Joe saying, you're a shit listener. But you were. It's very loud in there as well.
It is quite loud in there, and really hot as well, I can imagine. Is it when you're in there? Because they always say when you fight a different, not fight, even if you play any sport, at different temperatures, you know, you can't, I don't know the right word, you know, the more effort you put in normally, you'll be able to go longer. Is that what it's like when you're in there?
Yeah, it's definitely warmer, because the later the show goes on, the hotter and hotter that room gets. And it gets, sometimes it gets unbearable. I fought on a boxing show here, and it was main event, and I literally come out and I'm in. First minute, 2 minutes after the first round, I was dripping and pouring, and it was horrible. It was hard to breathe, but it's been like that at the gym over summer, so I'd say I got used to that, especially with the late heat wave we had at the back of September.
Oh, I bet that'd have been a nightmare.
At the gym, yeah, and then it's not as hot as the sauna was yesterday as well, so I prefer the gym.
There's good bits to it all.
Yeah, there is. No, I did my first ever weight cut. That was harder than fight.
I know people say that the cutting the weight is just like, you know, once you get through that, I bet it's like I bet the fight is the not the easiest part, but it's a bit easier.
Yeah, after that, and you can start eating and drinking, it's good. Like when I was weighing in yesterday, I was just waiting to weigh in, and just everyone being there, the whole team were just waiting for people to weigh in and chat to and have a laugh. Because I was just waiting to weigh in, I was really cranky. My mum hated me when I was dieting for this fight. Craig Heasley took the fight last, like, middle of the week, like I did, because my opponent, Diego Granda, pulled out from SBG. He pulled out, and so Craig stepped in, so it was completely different. I had to change my game plan a little bit, because I know he's got a heavy right hand, this Craig, so didn't, as much as I'm confident I can stand because I know I can. I've got the boxing experience for that. Something you have to be worried about. I don't want to get caught by one of them and foul.
So. Wake up on the floor and wonder, and he's diving on you. Yeah. I know that's quite an imposing sight when people do that to you, but I know you're waiting to speak to your mum again as well. You said your phone battery died.
Yeah,
so
don't let her know I'm still alive. I'm fine all the time, but she worries. Like, one of them brought me out, another one. Last one I got a couple of me. A couple of miles, that's just a scratch, so it's fine. Chris said it was a scratch, it'll be all right.
That's what mums are like, aren't they? But I'm sure she'll be really proud once you show that belt, and you've got no marks on your face this time, so I bet she'll be like...
Work will be happy with that.
Yeah, just walking.
Oh, my boss, he'll give me shit, he'll be like, oh, fine again, he always goes and thinks, oh, I bet he's been beat again. And some at work colleagues are out there, they get the privilege of going like... No, he actually won.
Actually, sir.
So now I'm going to go to work on Monday and just go, hey, oh, Trev, have a look at this.
And then just chuck it at him because it's heavy and he'll drop it and you'll go, really?
Yeah.
But is there anyone you want to thank or give a shout out to?
Rob Friedman for giving me the opportunity and the time. He's been there. I've been had a few difficult years and he's been there for me. The Preds team's like a family. I've got to really thank them, especially Chris Leeson. He's like my best mate, and many people confuse him for my brother or me for him. So, you know, he is like a second part of my family, extended family. Wayne, he always calls me down. My mate Moore, he got me into the sport and at Preds. All the guys at Preds and my friends. And a big shout out to my friend Aaron Murphy, because on one of my fights, I think it was one of the fights earlier, I was a bit apprehensive and nervous about it all, we're taking it. And he said to me, if you're nervous to fight people and you don't want to fight people because you're scared of getting beat, you're in the wrong sport. And I took that on board, and it's a good little thing. Always got to be ready to fight people better than you, because then you can show you're a better fighter yourself. And I think I showed that today against Craig. He's an experienced fighter. He's had quite a lot more fights. I think that was his 8th MMA fight now. It was only my 2nd, so I'm proud of that. Yeah, all them guys and Preds, my family and friends, got to thank them.
Yeah, well, you didn't look like you'd only, that was only your 2nd fight. You were very calm throughout, and like you say, you gained something whether you win, lose or draw, and especially with a nice little belt there you can keep.
But I gained a lot of experience and some things I know I need to work on and I want to work on, and onwards and upwards I can improve as a fighter myself. Still early doors, I'm still quite young, so...
I can't wait to see what comes from you, if that's just early doors and you've still got all them years, as they say, to compete. I can't wait to see it again, and thanks so much for your time.
Thank you.
Cheers.